Hey guys, so day three of EDC Orlando 2021. Right now it's I think 11:31 if I'm correct, a.m. And right now I'm heading into Universal Studios just to pass the time a little bit until I'll leave later and try to catch a Lucii set. And yeah, after that, I'll let you guys know. Keep you updated. So, bye. Okay guys, so we're heading to this one. This is gonna be the first ride of the day. So we just did the, well, I just did the Hulk roller coaster. It was pretty cool. It was really a little rough, but still really cool. I did enjoy myself. My parents went to ride next to it, like the Storm for X-Men ride. And now we're headed to the Velasa coaster. We're gonna do that one. Coaster ride, you know, they gave us a time to come back and enter the ride, but for now I'm in Harry Potter, as you can see, and drinking some famous bar beer. Really good, really good. I really doing good. So yeah.
Your park ticket to re-enter the locker after riding. Remember to keep your park ticket with you at all times.
So hey guys, me and my mom just did the Velocicoaster. My dad couldn't do it because he got anxious and wanted to leave. You know, he got really nervous. So yeah, me and my mom did it, and this is a freaking amazing. You know, real scary. You know, fast, obviously, but overall really enjoyable. You know, your turns and upside down even. And it was really enjoyable, and yeah, just really recommend it. But you know, you suffer from anxiety or stuff like that, you know, you should, you know, then it's better be safe than sorry. So don't do it if you're feeling suffer from all the stuff. So yeah, but if you don't, then go right ahead and enjoy it.
I know. so.
So hey guys, I just left Universal and now I'm on my way to the, you know, the event. So here we go.
Thank you.
Yeah, I'm getting in the zone.
Thank you for watching my video, and yeah, I just wanted to give you more of an update, you know, recap what happened that day. So as you already saw, I went to Universal Studios and did the Velocicoaster for the first time. I also went to and did Star Wars The Resistance. Never done that. It was really cool, really, you know, interactive. I wasn't really expecting it to be that way, so that was really cool. And yeah, at the end you saw that I went to the festival again, and I went to see, I wanted to catch Lucii's set, but I couldn't do that, unfortunately. Then I managed to see Jstjr with Cream, which for me has to be the most underrated set of that day, at least. And after that, I think I went to see Joyryde at Kinectic Field. Really enjoyed that set. And there, I met a group of people that were so freaking cool and nice to me that I hung out with them for the rest of the night. And then we went to see Jaws. And it was really amazing. And after that, then we parted ways. You know, I kept their information, you know, like their Snapchat and Instagrams. We had each other. So that was really cool. And yeah, now we follow each other. So something good came out that night, and yeah, I made some friends, so really good. And also, since it was the last day of the event, I also had to buy some stuff. Obviously, I couldn't leave there empty-handed, so I bought some stuff. Got a lot of merch throughout the weekend, so I'm gonna show you what I got on the end of the festival, and then gonna show you what I bought throughout the weekend. So here we go. The first thing that I got was this beanie. Now this, I love EDC beanie. I got that. Then I also got a shirt of the EDC. Got, you know, this one. I wanted to get the one with the, they had like, I think the lineup, but they didn't have it in my size. So yeah, unfortunately I can't get that one. I just saw one for, you know, Excision, you know, the X and the Headbanger, but they didn't have it in my size either, so yeah. Now, the stuff that I bought throughout the weekend, I got a lot of stuff from like stores like Sumius, Banana Republic. So yeah, I got this shirt, this Jujutsu Kaisen shirt, with this hat,
jump. So you can see it. There you go. More clear. And at first I was just planning on buying the shirt until I saw the hat and I tried it on and I saw that it looked really good. I mean, a really good combination. So I decided, fuck it, let's get the hat as well. Then I got this one, this shirt right here. No, not shirt, but you know, like a long shirt. This one was quite unexpected. It was one day we went to the outlet mall and we went to Banana Republic, and I really wasn't thinking of buying anything there until I saw this one and I tried it on and it looked really good on me, so I decided, why not? Also, I got this one, the Goyo, also used the Kaizen, and as you can see in the back, I just saw it and I had to have it. And I got this one. This one, I think, was on the first day we arrived. We went to Outlet Mall and we went to a store that I forgot the name right now, but Vineyard Vines. And I really wasn't planning on buying anything there, but my parents were grabbing stuff, and I think I saw this one and it kind of appealed to me. I thought it was really cool, so I tried it on, I liked it, and then yeah, I bought it. Okay, now this one. This is just like a standard, like a long sleeve, like your basic stuff. This one is sick, but fuck, I don't give a shit. The point is that I tried this on and I really liked it. I like how different it felt from the other stuff I'm used to wearing. I always go for like your typical Hot Topic stuff because that's my favorite store. So this was new for me and I said, why not? Let's have it. And also, I got when I was in Universal, I think. Yeah, no, not Universal, in Hollywood Studios, that I bought this shirt. Yeah, I saw that one and I really liked it, and it was the most cheapest one, honestly, because the rest of them were really, really expensive. So yeah. And I got some other stuff after I came back, because before, I went to work, I went to see My Hero, the new movie of My Hero Academia, World's Mission, I think, World's Heroes Mission. And yeah, I got some shirts here. I got one shirt. I got this one, the Deku shirt, and I also got another shirt, Kakashi Hatake shirt. It's also green as well, and it's kind of the same style as this almost, but right now I can't show it to you guys because it's out on the being dried up right now, so yeah, unfortunately I can't show it to you guys. But yeah, that's it. That's the stuff that I got throughout my weekend at Florida. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please leave a like and subscribe if you want to. Click on the notification bell to keep you updated on my next videos. And yeah, I'm going to be doing reviews again, obviously. I know I'm way behind. I gotta do the Ivy Bleep Bloof EP, the Plague Dreamer EP. Also, the other ones that I want to do that came out recently was Rest Spiral album, because I haven't heard anything of that album. I think there's Sims False EP, and then I hopefully am planning on doing since they already announced the winners and runner-ups for the Disciple second biggest remix competition of all time. I made a list of it. Posted here. This is the list that I made of what I would consider to be the winners and the runner-ups if I were making, the decision of who should win. And yeah, this is the ones that inspired the most. I'll keep you more updated and when I do the video. Yeah. But yeah, that's it. And thank you for watching. And this is DuckSec signing off. I'm gonna say